In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of muscles that do internal rotation and external rotation of shoulders. In first part, I'm going to explain internal rotation. In second part, I'm going to explain external rotation. This is superior view. You are looking scapula and humerus from above. Let me explain internal rotation first. I'm going to explain big muscles first. First muscle is kind of a, this big one. This is pectoralis major. Pectoralis major. Origin of pec major is clavicle. You don't see it, but there is sternum and ribcage. But this level. This is origin, and this is about insertion. Usually, when muscle contracts, vector of force is from insertion to origin. Basically, of course, there is some exception, but basically, the vector of contraction is from insertion to origin, like this. Now, what kind of movement is going to happen? That is, of course, internal rotation, right? This vector creates internal rotation. Very easy to understand, right? Next one is close to pec major. This muscle is like this. This is deltoid. Particularly anterior fiber. Okay, deltoid anterior fiber. Again, vector of contraction is from insertion to origin. So it's like this way. This vector creates, of course, internal rotation. Number two is deltoid. Then number three is a little bit tricky. Actually, this is elbow muscle plus shoulder muscle. That muscle is from like this. Imagine like this. This is. Then here. This is biceps brachii. Biceps brachii, particularly long head. Long head originates from superior part of scapula. Imagine it's like here. So force of vector is like this way. This creates internal rotation. It's a little bit hard to visualize, but this is how that is. So these muscles are on front part of ribcage and shoulder, right? Pec major, deltoid anterior fiber, and biceps brachii. That makes sense. Next one is also in front part. This muscle originates from anterior part of scapula. Imagine this originates from here and it attaches like this. Imagine this pink one is the muscle. This originates from anterior part of scapula. This is subscapularis. Subscapularis. This is part of rotator cuff. Imagine this pink one is subscapularis. Origin is anterior part of scapula. Insertion is here. Which way is vector of muscle contraction? This way, right? This way, this way. This contraction brings to internal rotation. Simple enough. Subscapularis. This is part of rotator cuff. Now, let's go to next one. Next one is even more complicated. This muscle originates from kind of lateral part of scapula and slightly it's got kind of posterior part. Then it goes like this. Origin is lateral part, okay? Then insertion is actually front part. Imagine this purple is the muscle. This is teres major. Okay? Its origin is on lateral part and posterior part of body. Then, it goes to anterior part of humerus. Then, when this muscle contracts this way, this movement creates internal rotation because its origin is on posterior part of body. Insertion is anterior part of humerus. This creates kind of this spiral movement. This vector creates internal rotation. That makes sense. Last one from internal rotation. That is also from posterior part of body. Imagine it's from like this, this, this. Then it attaches to anterior part again. It's like this. This is huge muscle. This is latissimus dorsi. Latissimus dorsi originates from back part of body, then it inserts to anterior part of humerus. Its orientation is like teres major. Then this movement creates internal rotation. There are six internal rotators. Pec major, deltoid anterior fiber. They are easy to understand. And biceps brachii, long head. Subscapularis, teres major and latissimus dorsi. See, if you look shoulder from above, it's easy to understand. Let's go to external rotator. Okay, there are three external rotators of shoulder. Easy thing is they are all from posterior part and go to posterior part. Easy, yay. First one is it's like this part. Okay, kind of this way. This is deltoid, posterior fiber. Deltoid, posterior fiber. Remember, anterior fiber does internal rotation, but posterior fiber does external rotation because vector of force is this way. Yeah, it's easy to understand. Let's go to number two. Number two is also from back part of scapula. Then it attaches to back part of humerus. Contraction goes this way. This makes external rotation. What is this? This is infraspinatus. This is one of rotator cuff. That from posterior part and it finishes up at posterior part. Yay. Last one is also part of rotator cuff. It's from a lateral part of scapula. It's like teres major. Then it goes like this. However, this is not teres major. This is teres minor. This is also part of rotator cuff. Teres minor originates from kind of back part of body, right? And it inserts to back side of humerus. Do you remember? Teres major originates from back part of body, then it goes to anterior part of humerus. Again, this spiral orientation creates internal rotation because of this direction. But teres minor originates from back part of body, then it attaches to back part of body. This simply creates external rotation. Again, if you look shoulder joint from superior view, it's easy to understand the direction of muscle. Thus, it's easy to memorize their function. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button. comment, and subscribe. See you next video.